What's going on, VFXers? My name is VK and welcome to a brand new exciting Phenomenal Creations video tutorial, the channel that helps you improve your skills in film post-production like After Effects, DaVinci Resolve, Fusion 16 and Premiere Pro tutorials like this one. If you are interested in any of those programs or Premiere Pro content like this one, definitely consider subscribing to this channel so you never miss out on a future video. Okay, so today we are gonna be working with one of my favorite seamless transitions inside Premiere, and I'm basically going to show you a couple techniques that you can basically use however you want. This is basically more to showcase a technique that you can then utilize instead of a very specific look of a transition that you can only use in very specific cases. I'm going to show you a really, really cool technique on how you can do seamless transitions in Premiere Pro. They do require a little work, but the best transitions do. So let's go ahead and see here. I have my timeline here. We can see a little clip here and what we can see here. If we go ahead and press play, that we have our house. And just very seamlessly, it just changes from one clip to another, almost like it seems that they are pieces of the same footage, even though all of the clips are for different locations. So how we do this, we accommodate two very known techniques. We're using speed ramping on slow motion footage. You don't have to use slow motion footage if you don't want to. You can also just shoot footage really slow on your hands if you're good with that. But we're going to do some speed ramping to hide a little bit of the imperfections between the cuts. And then we're going to do some cool masking animations to basically merge two clips to one another. So I think there's a lot of cool things you can pick up from this tutorial, but let's go ahead and skip the chit chat and let's just jump into the tutorial. Let's make this juicy. Hope you guys all doing well and you're ready to do this. Hey, if you guys do like this so far, definitely give a like to this video, because now you're going to be learning something really cool and powerful. Let's go. Okie dokie, we are ready to start working. Here we have a couple pieces of footage that I have shot for this tutorial. And I'm gonna link this down if you want to use my footage for your training purposes. You're all welcome to do that. But I really urge you to try with your own footage. And I would really love to see your work. So definitely link me up to my socials, tag me to my social accounts, your results of the same techniques. And I just really wanna see how that looks like. It's gonna be really cool. So I'm gonna take here a footage of this house here. If I double click on there, I already have made a selection of the clips. What part of this clip I want to use, you can just use the I and O keys on your keyboard to create your in and out points. I'm just gonna drag this here to the timeline. We're not gonna use the audio in any way because this doesn't have audio. So this is the first clip, just the house here in 120p slow motion, 1080p, just this kind of action right here. That's the first clip. Then we have our second clip, which is right here. It's the bike part here. So let's go ahead and select that, put it here. It doesn't have to be this long. Let's delete that audio and put this to the track underneath. To begin with, I like to do that. Now we can see here's the 120p of that bike coming down. Okay. The first thing we're going to do is to play with some speed ramping. So I'm going to show you a quick speed ramping technique. If you want to go more in depth about speed ramping, definitely leave a like to this video. I can create a speed ramping tutorial, but there's also a bunch of tutorials out there if you just want to learn speed ramping as a whole. So what we're going to do here is that let's go ahead and zoom into this little section here. So what I want to do is that I want this to start off slow, and then I want it to speed up once it goes closer to this little roof and this waterline rail here. And then from the second clip, I want it to begin fast and then smooth out in the beginning. So we're pretty much creating this ramp of speed between these two clips to hide a little bit of that masking we're gonna be doing later on. Helps with the seamlessness and also gives a nice flow when not everything is slow 120p. And we get some speed ramping over there. So how we do this, if we're going to go here and we can see on this clip, we have this little effects button here on the left top corner. Let's right click that and we get different options. We get motion and opacity. Basically, we get different parameters to control effects on this layer directly on the timeline. But we're going to go to time remapping and speed. And we can see that the middle line here, which is normally the opacity slider, becomes now a speed slider or speed graph in the middle of the scene here. And that is indicating 100% speed, so normal playback speed. So what if I would now click and drag and take this up, we would speeding up the clip like this. So now it's faster, but we want to animate this. Let's go back and undo that. So let's go ahead and find the point where I want this to speed up, somewhere around here. And then what I'm gonna do is go hit, hold down the command or control key, depending on your Mac or PC, click on there on that timeline where we want to do that. We can see this little marker appearing on the timeline. Then I'm gonna go to this right section, which I want to speed up. I'm gonna go there, click and drag, and just drag this upwards. We can see this little percentage value also changing. We can see how much we are basically manipulating the speed here. I'm gonna take this down for all that 300%, usually it's pretty good. We can see the clip shortens afterwards. Obviously, if we speed up the clip, it shortens. So now if we just, let's kind of move this here closer. Let's see how this looks like. So we have that smoothness and then it becomes pretty quick there. And it's really fast. And also it just suddenly starts speeding up. It's not smooth. It's really slow. And then just boom, in a second, it goes really quickly. So we can actually take this down just a touch, make this a little bit longer like this. So how do we make this a little bit more smoother? Okay, let's go ahead and zoom into this. We can see this little gray marker, which we noticed in the beginning. If we select that to make it blue, we can see this little, on our pointer, we can see this little side-to-side angle arrow kind of thing. We can click and drag this to the left or right to create this little ramp. Basically, a little transition ramp from that slow playback speed to the fast playback speed. So we get like a ramping action. So let's see how that looks like. It's already better, but it could be a little bit smoother. And how we do that is that we're going to just select it and we can get this little tool here in the middle. I'm not actually sure what it's called, but let's call it like a ramp pick whip for the sake of the tutorial. If we go ahead and now turn this to the right, we can see that we are now creating a smooth curve. Let's go ahead and make this a little bit bigger so we can see better what we're doing here. This smooth curve that now it begins in normal playback and smoothly accelerates and then smoothly deaccelerates. Yeah, doesn't accelerate anymore in there. So let's go see. That looks already pretty good. That we have that smoothness going in and then it pretty smoothly ramps up the speed, almost seeming like that we are doing the motion in hand, which is pretty cool. Okay, we have that. So basically what we're gonna do now is that we're gonna do the exact same thing on the second clip, but in reverse. So, and also you can apply, you can also, now when you have added this, you can also move this around to happen at different sections of the time. You can lengthen this, shorten it. You have really much control of how you want to speed ramp and where you want to do it. And you can also do it afterwards, which is pretty cool. Now let's go ahead and do this exact same thing. I'm going to skip a little bit forward because I have already showed you how to do this. So we're saving a little time. Let's go into time ramping speed. And I want this to happen when the logo gets visible. Let's go ahead and make this a little bit shorter, the clip. Like that. Like that. Ramp that up and make it smoother. Yeah, I think we can work with that. Now we have done the basic foundation for this transition. So we have now done the speed ramping. It doesn't look that good yet, but now we're going to do that seamless part about this. Let's go ahead and add some masking to this. Before we do that, because now we have added a time remapping control here, it will pretty much alter different effects. So what I usually like to do is that I select a clip, right click and click nest to make like a subsequence, like a precompose. So I'm just going to call this clip one here and then take the second one and call this clip two. The good part about this, if we now want to go and manipulate the time remapping, we can just double click and we can jump in to that subsequence and then play around with them if we want to. So now what I'm gonna do is gonna find the point where we want to add our mask. And in our example, I want to apply this here to this water ledge here. So when I'm coming down from the house, we can see that this wipes in front of the entire frame here. And also I can give this little pointer here. When you're shooting your own footage, try to have the motion to mimic each other. As we can see here, it's going from up to down and from up to down. So it will seem more seamless that it's a, like a one motion kind of type of transition instead of having this going from up to down and this would go from down to up. Your eye would notice it and it wouldn't look so seamless. So try to accommodate that those small things in motion that they are pretty much similar to each other. So basically shoot to edit and not the other way around. Don't have the fix it in post mentality here. Try to shoot the footage knowingly that you will create a very specific transition between them. That will make the transitions look so much better when you have put some thought behind it. Okay, so now let's go ahead and start do the masking here. So the moment I can see this little ledge coming in here, here I want to start the mask. What I'm going to do, go here to effect controls. If you don't see it, find it. It should be somewhere here in the left top corner between the project seamless, audio clip mixer, so effect controls. And then we have this little, underneath the opacity panel, we can see this little pen tool. We're going to select that. Let's go ahead and give us a little bit more space here. And then click that pen tool while having that clip selected. Then I'm going to go ahead and create like a box around this framing. And then at the end here, close the gap here where we want to accommodate for that ledge. Okay. So what we're going to do now next is that we're going to go ahead, click on this mask path, like stopwatch here to create an animation keyframe. So now if we go one frame forward, and let's have the mask selected. And now we move these two frames here to accommodate here. We can see where the ledge moves like this. And then if we go ahead and we can see that it applies a new keyframe, we go one frame forward again, do the same thing here. And we have already created a new keyframe. So now when we go frames backward, we can see that we have now animated this little thing here. So we're going to speed up while I'm finishing this up and then we're going to continue afterwards. Okay, so now we can see that we have added our animations pretty well here. Now let's go ahead and put some footage underneath here. Let's go to the first keyframe here. Like this. And we could actually go one frame forward and close this up so we don't have this like weird corner without anything on it. And now let's go ahead and go to this first frame here and have and drag this second clip we have here. So basically now we can see the transition happening, but it's a little bit sharp of an edge. So let's go back here. Let's go to the mask and go to mask feather to give this a little bit smoothness here. Like that, something like 50%. It really depends on what you like. And then you can also animate the mask feather if you want to have like a motion blurry type of action going on. Let's see how that looks like. All right. Not too shabby to say. It actually looks pretty cool. Pretty cool. Yeah. So now we have that really seamless type of feel between these two clips. And then you can also, at any point in time, you can jump in to the subsequences and you can manipulate how, for example, if you want to make this a little bit longer and this stuff, and we'll go to the second clip. Also, maybe adjust this a little bit, maybe put that later in time, go back to the clip here, and now we can see how it works. Really nice. And that's pretty much how to do that seamless transition type of action. Pretty much. It's not that hard. It's actually really easy. And then you can do it however much you want. I also have the second clip here. Did the exact same thing here. Had the pillar in the middle to be that transition point. But hey guys, now you know how to do this. Hope you guys did enjoy this tutorial. And if you did, don't forget to comment and like on this video. Consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't already and you want to see more of these kind of tutorials. Thank you guys so much for sticking around. And I'll see you guys in the next week's tutorial. Hope you guys did enjoy this. And I'll see you guys around. My name is VK. Have a good one.